Happy HBK Wellness Wednesday, everyone. Master trainer and wellness enthusiast Kiona Leah back with you guys again. And this week we are focused on twofers. That is right. All of our moves this week have at least two major functions that can make a big difference in your workout and the results that you get. So that's what we're focusing on. And tonight I chose one of my favorite sneaky little organs that also gives you a twofer effect. And that is, believe it or not, the gallbladder. It really doesn't seem like it. It seems like such an innocuous little organ. And if you kind of Google it and ask, what does a gallbladder do? You kind of get one thing. That one thing is very important, however, and it has a lot more impact than you think on not just your digestion, because the gallbladder itself, of course, its major function is to store bile that's been produced by the liver. And when you eat a meal, your gallbladder, which at the time is probably full, empties into your small intestine to help digest, especially help digest fatty foods. That's the primary function of your bile. However, there have been studies that show that there seems to be a link with bile production and digestion of sugars as well. So stay tuned for some more scientific studies on that coming up, because they are finding that gallbladder function can contribute in many ways to issues with diabetes and other blood sugar things of that nature, because digestion is digestion in many, many ways. So that's the primary function of the gallbladder, is to help support digestion and digestion of fat in a major way, because it's supposedly just a little storage facility, right? Which is why doctors have for many, many, many years been pretty cavalier about taking it out. It's not considered one of the life-giving organs. You don't need it to survive. And that is true. You don't need your gallbladder to survive. However, you do need your gallbladder to be healthy. Now, when I first started working within the TTAP system, a lot of people that I ended up meeting when I was a very new trainer had autoimmune disorders. I still meet quite a few people with autoimmune disorders in this system. The anti-inflammatory effects of the workout and the fact that those who are exhausted, drained, run down, limited in range of motion, other things of that nature, really tends to draw people to it with fibromyalgia, which was one of the first sets of people I started working with, lupus, and this one particular summer, Hashimoto's. It was just as I started working with my homeopath. So it was about 15 years ago or so. I had one summer where I had multiple Hashimoto's patients, or students, I should say. They were her patients, my students. And one of the things I noticed as I was working with them and started learning some of their medical history, especially because I was very new and very interested in things, I found this absolutely amazing corollary that didn't make any sense to me. These women all had either partial or all of their thyroid removed for Hashimoto's, as well as their gallbladder. And I said to my new homeopath, I said, what are the odds of that? And her response, 100%. And she said at the time, can't explain it, just know that it always happens. If the gallbladder goes, the thyroid goes. If the thyroid goes, the gallbladder goes. Thank goodness science continues to evolve, and now we're starting to see and understand and have answers to this question. The more we start to really understand how the thyroid works as a system with your hormones, the more it starts to make sense, the more the picture is coming into focus, which is really interesting as research advances. So what we were seeing is it is very cyclical. So your gallbladder supports your thyroid, supports your gallbladder, supports your thyroid, supports your gallbladder. Very, very important. So here's this little organ that we thought pretty much its only job was to support the liver. It doesn't. It supports the thyroid as well. One major thing that is found linking the two is your T4 hormone. When that starts getting low, it shifts the type of bile that is being produced in the liver, therefore what is being stored. It's thicker, it's sludgier, and it doesn't digest those fats nearly as well. Also, it actually is shown in some studies to affect how much bile the gallbladder actually stores, because the gallbladder responds to hormonal changes when you eat. So remember, eating is a very long process that starts in your mouth, goes through the esophagus and into the stomach and then into the small intestine, large intestine, and out from there. And so when things start, hormones shift in your body because the body realizes, oh, I get to eat now. I need to shift into digest mode. And those help signal the gallbladder to start releasing that bile. Well, if they're off balance because your T4 is off balance, that signaling is going to get interrupted and it's not going to work properly. As soon as that happens, the bile starts to thicken. It's not as effective. You're not digesting as many of your fatty acids, especially those healthy fats are not being digested. And now here's where we loop back from those fats that the gallbladder is heavily supporting digesting by storing that bile so that the liver isn't constantly producing it, constantly dumping it into the small intestine, and it's not diluted, because remember, while it sits in the gallbladder, it gets to concentrate more. That's its function, is to help that bile sit and concentrate so it's effective at digesting that fat. So that doesn't happen. Those fats that go back to the thyroid and help signal the body to convert T4 into T3 to help balance the metabolism, that connection gets severed without that gallbladder. And that is just going to set us up again to not produce the right amount of thyroid hormone, to not support the gallbladder, to create the correct signals for digestion to happen. And on and on and on this loop goes. So we really want to make sure, if we are starting to see issues with our thyroid, that we focus on heavily supporting the gallbladder as well. I've done a couple different videos about your gallbladder health and ways that you can cleanse it, supplements you can use to help support it and your liver, and things of that nature. Other big things to keep in mind when you're talking about your diet is make sure that you are getting plenty of fiber. Help keep things moving, help things keep things clean. And when you're talking about the fats in your diet, really focus on those healthy fats from your avocados, from your fatty fish, from your EFAs, things of that nature. Really focus on those. Interesting thing I saw is that somehow some studies are inconclusive about nuts right now. So notice I didn't put those on that list of those healthy fats that you should look to consume, because the jury is still out on nuts. For those of us that have a nut allergy, it's kind of a no-brainer. More avocado, please. More of my beloved salmon, please. And things of that nature, lots and lots of fish. But keep those two major things in mind, as well as really think about lowering your refined carbohydrate intake. Lowering, of course, we know our breads, our pastas, our cakes and cookies that we all love so much, really meant to be treats, but also think about things like potatoes and corn and your super starchy vegetables as well. Again, that's some of that preliminary research that they're looking at, where insulin and thyroid hormones are tied through some of how the gallbladder operates as well. So that arguably is my favorite little twofer organ that we have. It does more things than just store that bile. It really supports the thyroid as well as the liver. So it's got two organs that it's holding up and supporting. That's our twofer for the day. What other organs can you think of? Comment below and give me two things that you know that they do. I know there's plenty to choose from in the body. It's such an amazingly complex machine. What topics are you guys curious about for next week? It's the first week in April, so we're starting over, looking for new topics of interest for the classes and for these talks as well. Don't forget, comment, like, share, and subscribe. It means so much to me each time I see a new subscriber on my list. And in the meantime, I'm Keona Leah. I want to see you move, live, and thrive. So I'll see you on the next one.